What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. I just watched the other night's episode of Married at First Sight, and I just, like, the thing that jumped out most to me was Christina's living situation. Before we even jump into that, first of all, Olivia, oh girl, I think your true colors are starting to shine through. I originally thought she was like the sweetest girl who's ever appeared on Married at First Sight, and I felt as though Brett was gonna hurt her. And now after watching the way she was so judgmental and like looking down on Brett's living situation, he owned a beautiful house. Sure, it wasn't decorated like completely, but that's okay. Like, it's great that you have the opportunity to move in with him and turn that house into a home. But she was like, his house isn't that great. And she just never smiled once or told him anything positive about his home that he owned. And she talked up her own home, which, listen, it was okay decorated, but that bathroom was incredibly, like, offensively pink. And furthermore, it's a home that she rents. So it only makes sense that they move into Brett's home. I don't know. I'm starting to have my doubts about Olivia, that she is as nice as she presented herself as being. Anyway, getting back into this Christina situation. Y'all, this girl, the way she has been just so snooty and bougie and uppity throughout the entire season, just to find out that the girl is homeless, I don't even know what to say to you. First of all, she was like, oh, Henry's never been out of the country. Henry's never tried this kind of cuisine. Henry's never tried this kind of alcohol. Henry's never done like paddle boarding. Like, she just kept acting like she was like up here and Henry was down there, like, you know. And then the house moves them into a free apartment to start their lives together for a couple of weeks. And then what they ask the contestants to do, or sorry, the spouses to do, is go to their own homes with each other, show each other around, decide which one they were going to be living in after the show, and then grab some things to bring into the apartment that the show is paying for to help ease the transition. So when they get to the show-provided luxury apartment, it was beautiful, it was huge, what happens? Christina immediately starts complaining. She doesn't like the sofa. She wants Henry to help her move it before they go to bed. She doesn't like the bedding. She doesn't like the bathroom. She doesn't like the guest bedroom. She doesn't like any part of the apartment, because I guess, you know, at that point I was like, oh, Miss Thang must be living in like a beautiful downtown loft of sorts, you know, because she did tell Henry that she lived in downtown New Orleans. So I assumed that that's what she was, you know, accustomed to wear something this beautiful was beneath her. And then they go to Henry's house and she is like, wow, like, he's got like no food in his fridge. His house is just like a total bachelor pad. Is he a minimalist? He's got like nothing in his house. Yippee, 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 yeah, 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 doo-da-day. All the negative things that you would expect to come out of this really pretentious woman's mouth. And then it's finally time to go to her home so that they could pick up some things from her home and that she could show Henry around, so he gets a little bit of a better vibe of who it was that he married. So they go to the car, and guess what Miss Thang says? She's literally, with a straight face, says, well, you know, like, most of my stuff is in California. I've got it in storage. I've already packed my stuff in my car, so let's just go to, like, you know, the apartment. Slow down. Wait a minute. Are we really going to gloss over the fact that this girl is homeless and she lied to Henry about where it was that she lived? She claimed that she lived in downtown New Orleans. Where? You know, you guys on Twitter skewered her, and I'm going to read some of the funniest tweets I found because it is just so hilarious. One of you guys was like, is she sure she lives in downtown New Orleans, or is that just where she parks her car? Oh my God. So there's a conspiracy theory going around that the reason why she didn't want to go into her home was because she doesn't have like her own apartment being a flight attendant. She might have like a crash pad that she shares with a bunch of other flight attendants. So like there's no real purpose of going in that way. But I feel as though if that were the case, she would have been very clear about that. All she said was, I have most of my stuff in California. Why? Henry asked you where you primarily resided. You said it was New Orleans. So most of your stuff should be in New Orleans. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't add up. And then she claims that it's a result of being a flight attendant. But no, like, there are plenty of flight attendants with like homes, you know, like, they don't all live out of their cars, Miss Thang. And she also said she had a bunch of stuff in storage as well. And like, she wasn't calmly explaining her situation. She literally just mumbled it all and then just told Henry, okay, let's go back to the apartment. You know, the apartment she was talking down on. You know, finally have four walls, a kitchen, a bathroom, and all you could do is pretend that you are above it all, Really, girl, really? Same thing with Henry's house. It's not my style either, but at least I've got my own place where I could compare it to and say, listen, let's live at my home. You know, Christina cannot exactly do the same with what I assume is some sort of a Honda Civic or something like that. Not that there's anything wrong with Honda Civics. I'm just saying, you know, if provided with the option to live in a Honda Civic or in an apartment or a home, I think 99% of us would choose to live in a home, right? Again, this is nothing against Christina's living situation. I am just laughing at how pretentious she is given the reality of her living situation. Anyway, you guys, let's get into some of the hilarious tweets that I saw online about the grand revelation on Married at First Sight. The Reigning Opinions podcast tweeted, Christina loves to cook, where? To which a follower responded with, on her car hood with a griddle, I guess. Someone else tweeted, I was so confused because I remember at the wedding her telling him where she lived. I guess that's just where she had her car parked. Someone else tweeted a video clip of someone very greedily scarfing down food as if he's never seen food before, with a caption that reads, Christina eating that TLC provided honeymoon food because she was homeless this whole time. Bloom tweeted, I can't believe she was walking around all unimpressed with his small kitchen and hot pocket dinner. Meanwhile, she's heating up bread on her muffler. Caitlin tweeted, for a homeless person, Christina sure does have an awful lot to say about Henry's place. So Christina, do you do all that cooking and baking in your car? Or... And then Ali had another funny one. Christina had the nerve to talk about Henry's place being small, but the whole time she lives here. And it's a video clip of like, the trunk of a car opening up to someone like it with their blanket. And one of the most savage dregs of all came from a Twitter meme page where she tweeted, Christina's like, yeah, I live downtown, with a gif of Squidward in a box asking for spare change. Oh my God, you guys truly let her have it on a line. And again, I don't think it's like a genuine rip on people in hard living situations at all. No, this is just someone who is so pretentious for literally no reason. You know what I mean? I feel like if she had the humility that Bennett had, remember Bennett built a very small like home for himself, you know, and he talked about how like shy he was to show it to his wife Amelia and that he hoped that she liked it and wasn't like disappointed in his financial situation, blah, blah, blah. Like he was real. Woody was real about living at his grandma's home and like hoping that, you know, that is okay, like with his wife. Like a lot of people are not none of these people are millionaires on the show, but they're all very honest about their living situations. No one else, not a single other person, complained about the free show-provided apartment, luxury apartment, but the one person who doesn't even have a home. You know, that is why she is getting dragged online, because how do you act like that when you live like that? It doesn't make any kind of sense, you know? Anyway, you guys, before I get too much into my diatribe about this girl and how much I cannot really stand her, what did you think about this week's episode of Married at First Sight and Christina turning out to be like, what's the name of that guy? Matt Gwynn, a homeless person on Married at First Sight. Did the experts fail yet again, or do you buy her? I'm a flight attendant, so that's why I don't have a home. You know, I feel like if that were a valid thing, why is her base in California? Aren't flight attendants' bases usually where they're from, like where they choose? Why would she tell her husband that she mainly lived out of New Orleans, is what I mainly mean. Like, you clearly don't. You mainly live out of California. So who is she lying to? Is she lying to her husband? Or does she lie to the casting people, you know, just to be on this show? I don't know, you guys. I don't know. A lot of people on the show have proven to go to extreme lengths to lie. So maybe, just maybe, Christina does have a home, but it's in California, and she scammed everybody just to get on the show and get married. What do you think about everything? And how do you feel, by the way, real quick, how do you feel about Henry letting her know that the reason that he's not really quick to open up to her is because she is just so high maintenance and like complainy all the time, and her reaction to it? Make sure to let me know all of your thoughts and your opinions in the comment section down below. And as usual, we'll chat. That's all for now. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.